may think that I'm talking foolish. You've heard that I'm wild and I'm free. You may wonder how I can promise you now. This love that I feel for you always will be. But you're not just time that I'm killing. I'm no longer one of those guys. As sure as I live, this love that I give is gonna be yours until the day that I die. Oh baby, I'm gonna love you forever. Forever and ever, amen. As long as old men sit and talk about the weather. As long as old women sit and talk about old men. If you wonder how long I'll be faithful, I'll be happy to tell you again. I'm gonna love you forever and ever, forever and ever, amen. They say time takes its toll on a body, makes a young girl's brown hair turn gray. Honey, I don't care, I ain't in love with your hair. And if it all fell out, I'd love you anyway. They say time can play tricks on a memory, make people forget things they knew. It's easy to see, it's happening to me. I've already forgotten every woman but you. Oh darling, I'm gonna love you forever. Forever and ever, amen. As long as old men sit and talk about the weather. As long as old women sit and talk about old men. If you wonder how long I'll be faithful, I'll be happy to tell you again. I'm gonna love you forever and ever, forever and ever, amen. I'm gonna love you forever.
Well, all I can say is things have been pretty good ever since.
That's funny. That's one question. So here we are. There's no more than 10 of us. In 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, okay. We're
all you're a little close there, Mike.
I know, right?
Social distance.
We were shaking hands earlier.
I love you, but the distance is fine, man.
Yeah, exactly.
What have you been doing?
You know what? I'm like everybody else. I've been sitting home.
Doing that?
Yeah.
What we all do is so go, 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 go. People see the schedule online. They look on the website and see that. And you may see two dates here, three dates there. What they're unaware of, and they wouldn't have any reason to know, but right. What all is going on
behind the
in
scenes.
Between. Yeah. That often, you get your rest when you go on the road. And I you've heard this too. How many people have rode the bus with us? They've never done it before. They get on the bus and ride a weekend. Oh, yeah. And when it's over, in some form or fashion, they'll say something like, I don't know how you guys do this. And yeah. That's just one weekend.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's like going on vacation. You know, when you're gone from home, you need to come home so you can catch up on rest. You know, but that's, it's people think we're on vacation every weekend, but it's work.
A lot of work.
You know, the singing is the easy part. And that's the most, you know, joyful of all of it. But it's the miles and it's the work to get there.
Yeah. Which brings me to the next question. when you left, you took your songs.
Well, hey,
you took your songs with you.
Well, no, I'm writing all the time still.
Still.
And yeah.
Be honest, I was wondering because I knew in a managing a group what you were taking on, and I was wondering how, candidly, how's that going to work? Because writing creatively.
Oh yeah, you got to have time to be quiet.
Yes.
It's like you're talking, time to refresh and get your mind in the right place. But you know what? I've had to schedule writing. Before, I just wrote, you know, all the time. Mm-hmm. And if I was inspired, I'd just drop everything and go write. Now I have to schedule it, you know, because there's so many things to do. But you know, you find time, and when you have a song that is bubbling up inside of you, you've got to get it out. You know, and so for me, you know, I'm always thinking about a song and trying to write, and so, you know, it'll come out. If the song needs to find its wings, it will.
Our beloved record company at the time, I don't mind calling them out because they admitted they were wrong, but they didn't think we should cut this song.
Oh, yeah.
Because it has green beans and
casserole
and sweet tea and all that stuff in it. I think this started because we talked about sweet tea so much.
You were going to get a joke.
So you wrote this song. We took it to them and they didn't want us to cut it. We cut it anyway. And then several months later, they brought a big plaque for a number one song.
Y'all believed in it when nobody else did, yeah.
We knew it. Well, a lot of people, look, if you're over 40, you can appreciate this song. It goes like this.
Tablecloths are red and white. The tea is sweet and cold. The lines are long for that good fried chicken and green bean casserole. Old folks all at Fanny. The young kids are at play. The preacher asks the blessing. It's a scene that seems to say, welcome to the family, you can feel at home here. There's a lot of love that goes beyond these years. There's nothing like the fellowship of those who love the Lord. So welcome to the family, there's always room for more. We all feel like napping on a Sunday afternoon, but we stick around. And the songs are new or old. There's something in the harmony that's speaking to my soul. Welcome to the family, you can feel at home here. There's a lot of love that goes beyond these years. There's nothing like the fellowship of those who love the Lord. So welcome to the family, there's always room for more.
Jim.
Oh man, thanks.
Jim, I remember when you were with us, we talked you had a lot of the same influences that we have. And the interesting thing is Paul also has those same influences. Yeah. He grew up in Gadsden, Alabama. We're from Tampa. You're from Houston.
Yeah.
And we all listened to the same people. And the only difference was that we got by with it. You got better. Yeah. You had to sneak out and go listen to Chicago.
Yeah, my dad's in heaven, but my mom, if my mom watches this, she won't know this, but I used to sneak out to the back of our property, and there was an old station wagon car. Yeah. It didn't run, but the battery was still hooked up, so it still had until it ran down. I'd go in there, and I'd listen to Chicago and Journey and the Eagles, and you know, Lionel Richie, I remember
hearing. Oh, my gosh.
And I love that stuff. You. And and you know what? Gospel, I loved the gospel of the Gaither Vocal Band, the Cathedrals, the Tallies, Gold City, groups like that. But I also loved Journey and the Eagles and all those groups. And they, you know, their harmonies just mesmerized me.
Yep.
And that's the thing, when I heard you guys, I mean, you could hear the influence.
You hear the influence,
the Gatlins, you know, and the Eagles, and just great music, you know. And so, yeah, I had to discover a lot of that stuff a little bit later because I wasn't allowed to listen to it. I was only allowed to listen to the gospel stuff. But you know what? Great music is given to us by God, and those notes are God's.
They're His notes.
It just, I'm fascinated by the harmonies of those groups.
Absolutely.
So, that's what's great to sing with two brothers that sing together so well is the harmony, the blend.
Well, and the cool thing was whether it's sing with you, sing with Joe Smith, Joseph, or Paul, or whoever, you know, these are, we can give a reference. Hey, you remember this song? Oh, yeah. And you immediately start singing it. And you can do that, Paul did. Everybody, and that's why we gelled so quickly together, I think.
People would ask me sometimes about the blend of this group. They say, you know, everybody sings harmony. Mm-hmm. But I always said the difference is the blend.
Like a child by the seashore, building castles in the sand, foolish dreams I have dreamed day by day, leaving God out completely. Till the day my castles grand fell apart in the tide and swept away. In each life storms will gather, rains descend and wild winds blow. Wise the man anchored fast. Are you then like that wise man? Are you anchored? Do you know you are safe till the storms of life are past? Castles built on the sand, though they seem to be so grand, will surely melt away. For in life's raging storm, they cannot stand. In the rock of the ages, all my hopes are built today.
Sing harmony, but to blend, and you guys naturally blend, you know, brothers, it's that family harmony, and so it can be intimidating, but it's a lot of fun to sing with two brothers that can blend, and it's the blend, it's saying the vowels alike, it's the vibrato, it's the timbre, you know, it's the tone, it's
the swells.
I love that stuff. Yeah,
all the men that we have had the privilege of singing with all understood you're taking three voices, you're making one sound.
Absolutely.
And that's what all you groups coming up, you want some advice?
Yeah.
Really. It's not about you and your part, okay? No. Get together and make one voice with all three of those parts or all four of those parts. It's not three or four individuals up there. Come together. That's what a band is.
You bet.
That's what you, that's what, why you get such great harmony. So, I bet your mom can still swing a belt.
Yeah, I'm a little too big for her to whip, but she could if she wanted to. I'd probably let her.
I was working in town one afternoon, attending some business affairs. I heard a commotion a couple streets over and wondered what's happening there. A young man was running from in that direction and stopped just to catch his breath. I asked him to please tell me what was the hurry. He smiled up at me and he said, I was trying to catch the crippled man. Did he run past this way? He was rushing home to tell everyone what Jesus did today. And the mute man was telling myself and the deaf girl he's leaving to answer God's call. It's hard to believe, but if you don't trust me, ask the blind man, he saw it all. Oh, ask the blind man, he saw it all. My friend, if the struggles and burdens you carry are heavy and dragging you down, you've tried everything you can possibly think of, there's no relief to be found. That very same Jesus that altered the future of a blind man, the deaf and the lame, is still reaching out in your hour of trouble. One touch and you're never the same, and you'll be trying to catch the crippled man. Did he run past this way? He was rushing home to tell everyone what Jesus did today. And the mute man was telling myself and the deaf girl he's leaving to answer God's call. It's hard to believe, but if you don't trust me, ask the blind man, he saw it all. Go ask the blind man, he saw it all. He saw it all.
All right, now this one. Well, all of them, we've not sung together in forever.
A long time.
A long time. So we'll do the best we can. And we just did Castles in the Sand. That worked out pretty good. We knew that one. The rest of them, we don't really know all that well.
I'll make the words up. I'm a songwriter.
Make them up. I hope we do Bill Proud on this one. Bill Gaither, Larry Gatlin wrote this one. Goes just like this.
I wrote a few songs that gave a few people hope. Every once in a while I started a fire. When they asked me up there, what did you do down there? I say it was my heartfelt desire to play in the band, write a few songs and sing in the choir.
Some think you gotta be the big dog and lead all the little dogs around.
You gotta sing a solo, preach a great sermon, or be the biggest, hottest thing in town.
Well, I guess I'm just a simple man with a simple desire.
sang in a choir. I wrote a few songs that gave a few people hope. Every once in a while I started a fire. When they asked me up there, what did you do down there? I'll say it was my heartfelt desire to play in the band, write a few songs, and sing in the choir. I played in the band, I sang in the choir.
Yes, I did.
I wrote a few songs that gave a few people hope. Every once in a while I started a fire. When they asked me up there, what did you do down there? I say it was my heartfelt desire to play in the band, write a few songs, and sing in the choir. I played in the band, I sang in the choir.
Yes, I did.
I wrote a few songs that gave a few people hope. Every once in a while I started a fire. When they asked me up there, what did you do down there? I say it was my heartfelt desire. Heartfelt desire to play in the band, write a few songs, and sing in the choir. I played in the band, I wrote a few songs, and sang in the choir.
Wait for it, wait for it. The thunderous applause is going on. Hold on. Still going.
Played in the band, I sang in the choir.
Yes, I did.
I wrote a few songs that gave a few people hope. Every once in a while I started a fire. When they asked me up there, what did you do down there? I say it was my heartfelt desire. Heartfelt desire to play in the band, write a few songs, sing in the choir. I played in the band, I wrote a few songs, and sang in the choir.
I'm going to put us all on the spot here. Here we are in dealing
with... We're used to that.
Yeah.
Some things never change.
Yeah. You know, people often come up and said, because of the MC stuff, the funny stuff I do on stage, it's like, man, that's so impressive. You think so fast. Those things you say are so impressive. I said, you would be impressed what I don't say.
What you're editing out.
Oh, yeah. My gosh. That's
that's funny.
There's a lot. It's like a ping pong going.
I don't think that fast. Yeah. I can't edit that fast.
You know what you said one time? We were talking about MCing, and I think, help me if I get this right, and I'm chasing a rabbit off of what originally I was going
to
talk about.
Well, that's why we're used to that, too.
Surprise! Squirrel!
That's why we love you.
Yeah, but you're talking how you and some other MCs are concerned you might say the wrong thing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And therefore, it slows the process down of saying something because you're managing the editing it and go. And I think it sounds funny, but I don't mean it to be funny, but I think what I told you, and I think what guys like Mark Lowry and some of these, I think we know we're going to say something wrong. It's a foregone, it's going to happen. I'm just not afraid of it because I'll fix it. Now,
sure.
I'm not going to repeat them. There have been a couple times you think, yeah, I'd like to have that one back.
Yeah,
I can't fix that one. Well, you know, it's totally unintentional. You know,
it's funny. We all love it because we all love to laugh at you when you say it. But as a songwriter, I edit, you know, I write, I spend hours working on four, you know, or six lines or you know, just a couple lines.
Yeah, basically you're taking a sermon and trying condensing to it to 3 minutes.
So, you know, when you're on stage, that process is in my mind. With you, it's just, you know what, before I could think it, you said it. And so it's awesome. You know,
well, here's the other thing too. I have the advantage of, where you guys had to stand back there and wait. Bless your hearts. I know that's hard. But I've said the same thing, nearly the same thing every night. So you're able to tweak and add it. Sure. And then if something new comes on, you can add to it. When you take someone that hasn't done that and all of a sudden go, here's a crowd, talk. That's That's well, tough.
Yeah. I mean, it's like you said one time, somebody said, is what you do spontaneous? And you said, yeah, it was once.
It was once.
And if it works, you kind of build on it. Like, you know, people have asked me about being with you guys. They're like, you know that thing y'all did with the hats? And did you guys rehearse that? And go on, they said, no, we did it. And as we did it, it kind of evolved.
It grew.
You know, you felt the audience and you knew how far to go with it and what right. you know what would happen. So it
supposedly.
Evolved. And that's one of those things I'm trying to forget that we did.
I know, right?
But it was funny.
So here's what I was going to get true. To 10 minutes ago. We're here because we're not out touring and we're trying to stay engaged with the people. Yeah. But they may be as, they're, put it, they are as uncertain as we are. We don't know what's going on.
Sure. We don't have a clue.
So,
we don't.
My question, and this is putting us all on the spot, and I'll ask the question, I'll answer it first, give you guys time to think. What is God teaching you already? Because as Gloria Gaither says, you said it again, God is in the interruptions.
Right.
So in the prayer group, with which we love being a part of, Mark Trammell, Scott Fowler, Dean Hopper,
Gerald
Karen Peck,
Karen, Susan,
Daniel Ball, Susan
Wisnett. Yeah.
Just basically all the managers of groups are all in this together. We've been sending each other scriptures and videos and laughing a lot. And I thought about sending this. I hadn't yet because I'm formulating the thought. But if God's in the interruptions, He does some of His greatest work in our individual lives when things come to a halt. And we got to reevaluate. So mine is prayer. Prayer has always been a very challenging thing because I've always wrestled with this sovereignty of God versus free will. Yeah. And I won't get into all that, but I have a big battle with that, mm-hmm. which I think a lot of people do, truth be told. But I had a guy, and I did send this video to everybody. Somebody from Southwestern Seminary, I think, said, if you're uncertain of how to pray or what to pray, he said, pray scripture.
He said, Donald Whitney. Dr. Donald Whitney.
Donald Whitney.
That's awesome. Yeah.
Brilliant. Dr. Donald Whitney, look him up on YouTube, that particular thing. And he said, you read scripture, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Stop right there. Pray that. God, wow, I don't know what's going on. I may be walking through the manifestation, if you will, of the valley of the shadow, an example of that. You are with me. And so you pray that. So that's been very helpful to me.
Awesome.
So if I get anything out of this entire thing, that's huge. God doesn't waste these times.
No, I heard somebody say one time that God doesn't waste the pain He puts His children through.
And you've been through it in the last few
years.
You
know, we learn deeper truths when we're in pain because we're focused and we're listening. And God uses these times to teach us greater truths, to make us deeper, to make us more compassionate. It doesn't waste this pain. It will be for His glory and for our good. Mm. But in the meantime, it's not much fun. It's hard to go through these things. But I think for me, it's trust. Mm. Because as Ronnie and I were talking this morning, you know, we've never been in control. Even when the calendar's full and you feel like you've got your income, you've got your group, you've got things rolling just right, the bus is running, it's not in the shop, you know, those things. We're still not in control.
On the side of the road.
We think we're in control of that, but we're not. God is still in control. So He's teaching me to trust because in these uncertain times, we're not in control and we've never been in control. But He's capable. He's capable of handling this. So I think it's a trust matter for me.
Without question.
Put it in His hands and rest.
The Booth brothers have never been my supply. Never. The Lord is still my shepherd. I still don't need to want for anything. He's going to make me lie down in green pastures and lead me beside still waters. That's peace. That's abundance. Literally, it's a time where the rubber meets the road, if you will. You're going to trust Him or not, you know? And we got, there's people on payroll and there's a lot to consider here. Families to be fed. And we're talking to people who are going through the same thing. You've already been laid off. You don't know where it's going to come. You know what? Repeat the word back to the Lord. Here's what you said. You know, and go back to the cross. He's hanging there bleeding, paying for your sins and for our sins. You can trust Him, folks. And you know what? In one sense, it's kind of exciting. to see what he's
doing. See what he does.
Sometimes he sets the stage.
He's so creative.
Just so he can come through and show them.
Very much.
He can be dependent.
So maybe the conclusion is, we should all just relax and enjoy this little vacation we've been given. Because trust in the Lord with all your heart, lean not on your own understanding, in all your ways acknowledge Him. He will direct your path.
Wake into a dawn of uncertainty. Clouds of fear linger like the night. A day that feels so cold and dark and desperate. But I know where to find the light. I pick up the timeless, the truth that will remain, and read what will never change. Still, God is on His throne. The Bible is His word. The gospel changes lives, and every prayer is heard. His plans could never fail, not even one detail. His purpose will prevail. He was, He is, He will still. Into every life, disappointments come. Sometimes they're like a string of stormy days. But we can learn to look beyond the moment and see what's yet to be with eyes of faith. When we look for the eternal, hope rises like the sun. So trust, no matter what's to come. Still, God is on His throne. The Bible is His word. The gospel changes lives, and every prayer is heard. His plans could never fail, not even one detail. His purpose will prevail. He was, He is, He will. Still, He takes care of His children, and He inhabits their praise. Still, He calls all men to trust Him, and still He'll come again someday. Still, God is on His throne. The Bible is His word. The gospel changes lives. Every prayer is heard. His plans could never fail. His will prevail. He was, He is, He will still. I'm holding to the truth.
Good night.
The little things are the big things. It's the stuff that money cannot buy. The little things are the big things. We only get one chance to get it right. the big things.